on MWP9.
And it's to the vaccine. The most commonly reported.
Not cookie cutter.
Time. Save time. We never can become a system. Call 1-855.
Okay, welcome back to Rick's Radio Conversions. Today we've got Sergio's 1954 Chevrolet radio in. This was a 6-volt tube radio, AM radio. It's been converted to AM, FM, aux input, Bluetooth, and USB. And we're going to go over some of the various modes. Right now you're on the FM mode. To go to AM, you go off and then on again. Out there tonight. Unfortunately, I got some cloud cover for the AM stuff. So that's the AM and FM. To tune these, you don't pull the button straight out. You have to go towards the right and then out and then in. Just how that was designed. One of the other new features with the new board is there's a scan feature, and basically you go down towards the end of the dial there. You're going to take your tuning controller. You're going to go 12 to 2 twice.
Scanning for stations.
Now we're going to scan digitally across the dial.
Financial counselors just waiting to help you with your budget and your bills, and a great thing.
That she may make, seeing her elevated on that bench, actually raised up, will show little black.
And we'll let it go one more. So if you like that, you just grab your tuner.
Station hold.
And there you go. And then you can pull your push button out. And you know, set your station. And there's also a another thing you can do. We also have station identification. So this is an AM scale, so it's not an FM. So you can take your volume control 12 to 2 3 times.
FM 89.9.
Okay. Some of the other things you'll get too, you're going to get this push button switch. This helps out doing some of the controls when, you know, turning the knobs and stuff kind of gets confusing. You'll get a little cheat sheet that shows you how to do that. But the same thing for, this is a little bit different. So to figure out your station here, you just press it once.
FM 89.9.
A little bit easier. And it's going to be easier to do your virtual fader imbalance. And we're going to go over the tone here in just a minute. So when we do the tone, this does not have a traditional tone potentiometer. This has a tone switch. So what you'll do is you're going to go all the way over to the right. Now you're in tone mode. Now you're going to use your volume control. It's full treble. Full bass. Find out what you like. And what you'll do then is turn the tone switch all the way back to the left.
Volume hold.
As you said, volume hold. This is so that you can come back down and then be able to readjust the volume. Because if you were on max treble and we didn't do that, the speakers would be extremely loud when you went back to the volume control. Now, to also do your virtual fader and balance, okay, those are also used through the tone control, and this is where it gets kind of tricky. So what you would do is go back to tone, okay, and then virtual fader, you would go 12 to 2.
Fader adjust.
Gotta get the sweet spot. So that's fronts, rears, fronts, rears, So you hear that clunking sound, that's the null point. And then she'll say fader hold.
Fader set.
Or set rather. And now the same thing to do balance is 12 to 10. We are still in the tone mode all the way to the right.
Balance adjust.
That's full right. Full left. Full right. Full left. Okay, that's all the controls. There's your balance set. Go back to volume. Volume hold. Back down. Back up again. So one of the good things about the push button is that what we can do now is you're gonna do one quick press and one hold.
Fader adjust. Fader set.
Oh, I did that wrong.
Fader adjust.
There we go. So once again, back to tone, but instead of using the volume control, you can use this little push button here.
Volume hold.
You can do that both for balance and fader. Get a little bit different flavor of music. We get copyrighted a lot, but we'll be okay, I guess. And then we can do the same thing also. Actually, let me go back down here and show you this. So you can also scan with this as well. Four times on the button.
Scanning for stations.
Whoa has just
so now we're scanning for the stations.
And that was Crown Victoria from it. And we started that set off with.
And then when we we're only gonna let it go one more, and then we'll show you how to stop it.
Station hold.
Alright, so that's the that's the inner workings of how the tuner works. Sergio, if I were you, since I think this is a custom car, you know, you can mount your switch somewhere nice, your aux and USB control somewhere nice. So the aux mode, we're going to get into that now, okay? Standard 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. You're going to get that little jack down there to the left for your USB and your aux. And then you're just going to hit play.
Sweep on the left channel. Sweep on the right channel.
And that's how your aux
sweep
is going to work.
Left channel.
And if you want to stop that,
sweep on the right channel.
Just stop your device or unplug it. In 20 seconds, the radio will come back, or you can just turn it off and then on again. Next, we're going to do the USB. Get a USB stick. Fill it up with some songs. Now the good thing about the way the new device works is you want to go up on that up a song. I thought I had more than one song on here. There we go. Up on the dial, we'll fast forward. Reverse on the tuning dial, we'll go back a song. And you can also do the same thing, much like scanning for stations. Press once. Fast forward. Twice. That's how that works. It's a pretty cool gizmo. Alright. I think we're out of that. Alright, now we're gonna pair the radio. Go to your Bluetooth settings, and I don't know if you can see that very well. Maybe you can. So to pair, you're gonna either A, volume control 12 to 2 twice, or just press this once for 1 second. That right? I haven't done one of these in a while with a switch. Ah, press and hold. Press and hold.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Ready to pair. There we go. Select your device.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
So this your phone may or may not do announce the contacts. I always hit allow. Your phone may do that for you. It's a kind of a newer feature for phones. So now we are not no longer connected. That's not the right English, but we're no longer connected. We are streaming. Okay.
Sweep on the left channel.
Turn all the way up there.
Sweep on the right channel.
And then no matter what you're doing as far as, that didn't work out well. This is not the greatest thing, Same thing with, when you're streaming. Second, and go back to the last known radio station. And we'll give this about 10 seconds. Now you're going to do other things too, your voice commands. And it's best to kind of show you the screen if you have an iPhone. To do the voice commands, okay, if you want to use the actual radio to do this, press and hold. What time is it?
It's 8:30 p.m.
So that's part of the voice command process. We can also do some other stuff. You can also use the radio 12 to 2 on the volume. Play music. And we're going back to playing the music. Same thing like before. Tuner up on the dial. Now, some of the other things that the microphone, you're going to get, it's about a 6-8 foot cord running up the A-pillar. Ours is sitting up at the right rear speaker. If you didn't want to use the voice commands and you have an Apple, you can just do things like, hey Siri, pause music. Pause music. And now we're back to the radio. And then you can do things like, hey Siri, what's the weather going to be today?
It's currently clear and 46 degrees. Expect rain starting tonight. Temperatures will be fairly consistent, averaging about 53 degrees.
And there you go. And that is just talking out loud. I think there's a Hey Google thing or something. And once again, we are back to the radio, but we go back again. Hey Siri, play music. Play music. I always forget to wait for the ding from the when you tell it or do something. So, you know, those are and you can even do things like, hey Siri, play Eric Clapton. I don't know that you heard me. Hey Siri, play Eric Clapton.
Now playing.
So all kinds of cool stuff that you can do. I typically don't like to do a whole lot of this because we get hit with the copyrights. Some of the time the songs are really good and you just gotta do it.
Didn't think I knew how to rock and roll.
Sergio, thank you very much for letting us convert your radio. And if you want your radio converted just like Sergio, please contact Rick's Radio Conversions at 757-716-9305. You can also find us at ricksradioconversions.com. We're also on Facebook. Thank you. Bye.